work truly as a medievalist,
yes,
as an English professor, and I am a neuroscientist, I'm a reductionist, I study a couple of cells at a time. It doesn't really have much to do with literature. And yet, we can use the approaches that we are accustomed to taking in our own scholarly,
yes,
pursuits.
Yes.
And we can try to see how do those approaches actually serve in trying to understand how is it that people think.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, this is one of the things that brought us together, right?
Right.
This interest in thinking about learning as discovery, as exploration, mm-hmm, as open-ended.
Yeah. And that's how we ended up naming this class Thought Experiments.
Exactly. Yeah.
Ways of Knowing in Neuroscience and the Humanities.
I mean, this is the point of having a bunch of brilliant people working in different disciplines. You can't solve the big questions without looking at the problem from different angles. And we thought about, like, when we designed the course, having assignments that required students to do the same, including one where we paired up students from different disciplines as lab partners.
One of the really interesting assignments we had the students do was to write from the other student's perspective.
Yes.
And it sort of was a culmination of everything we'd been trying to do,
yes,
through the course, talking about how both literature and neuroscience offer ways of gaining perspective.
We have spent our careers asking similar questions, right? What does it mean to,
yeah,
be alive? What does it mean to be human? What is the language of the brain? How does that language move? How does language move, right? It's also clear that we think about scholarship as teaching too, which it is.
If you think about it, although neither literature nor the type of neuroscience I'm talking about is really focused on curing disease,
yeah,
we are curing something. And I think that what we're curing is ignorance. And as far as I can tell, ignorance is the disease that's caused more damage than all the neurological disorders put together. And ignorance is the one condition that all educators can be involved in curing.